Hello, John Talley here with PartZilla.com. Today I want to show you a few tricks on how to diagnose a no-start condition on our 2008 Honda CBR600RR. There's a lot of different factors that go into this, whether or not it's going to start up or not, but we're just going to focus on the actual motor turning over. So that's what we're going to aim for. So let me get this seat out of the way and we'll start picking it apart. So let's get started. Real simple, just a couple of 5mm Allen bolts. All right, let's start off with the really basics here. Let's say you turn on your machine and nothing's happening. Well, that's something systemic coming from the power source, which is the battery. So what you'll need to do is get you a meter, set it to DC volts, and let's take a look at this one. Now I know this one's in really good shape, but I'm just trying to show you the actual steps. All right, 12.85. Doesn't get much better than that. So what could be going on here? Obviously, the power in the battery is not getting out to the machine. So where you need to look is on top of this starter relay. Get the main plug out of the way. And under there, where those battery connections are, is a fuse. And this pretty much powers the entire machine. It all runs through this. And guess what? That one happens to be blown. But I knew that before we started. But guess what? I just happen to have another one in my pocket. Imagine that. What are the odds of that happening? So, replace our fuse, plug this back in, turn the key, and of course it's going to start right up, but we knew that was going to happen. All right, let's say that your battery's good, the fuse is not blown, you turn on the ignition, everything lights up, but you hit the switch and nothing happens. All right, here's what we need to look at next. What you can do is actually trigger it. What we're basically doing is completing the circuit like you're pushing this the starter button over there. It's just eliminate this switch as a possibility. So run this over to positive, and then we're going to go to the yellow with the red stripe on that four prong connector down there, and this should turn it over. Yep, sure does. But let's say you did that and it still didn't turn over. Next thing we want to look at is to see if this relay is actually functioning or not. And you're actually just listening to it. I want to show you what that sounds like. Now to do that, I'm actually disconnecting the starter cable. Otherwise, you know, it'd just fire right up and you won't be able to hear what I'm talking about. So we're just going to temporarily disconnect this. I just want you to listen to see what the relay sounds like. All right, we got it flipped on. That tells you that at least the contactor is moving inside the relay itself. All right, if you want to verify that with the battery disconnected, you could take your meter and put it on what they call a connectivity, just to see if it's, you know, making contact or not. And then go in between those two poles. Turn it on, hit your switch, hear the meter. So it's definitely making a contact. All right, guys, let's do a quick overview. I mean, if you know that you've got a good battery and you know you've tested out the switch, and then you know that you're making contact back here because you can hear it clicking back and forth, and you verify that it's actually contacting with a meter, chances are it's gonna be your starter. So, that being said, if you need any of these parts, come see us at PartZilla.com and we can get you taken care of. If you have a question or a comment, just leave them in the section below and I'll do my best to answer them. And until next time, we just wanna say thanks for watching.